In 1871, artist Thomas Moran first depicted the luminous cliffs and cloud-swept skies surrounding the railroad outpost of Green River, Wyoming. His ensuing meditations on this landscape ensured its longevity as an icon of the American West. An 1879 version in oil, The Mirage, presents a vivid study of his memory of the location's light, color, and expansive space, which is emphasized by the long horizontal canvas. A line of Native American riders moves through the calm water and bleeds into the inverted mirage of red rock. Their movement guides the viewer into the composition, while their scale underscores the vastness of this landscape and the gravitas of its ancient guardians. Nearly seven decades later, film director John Ford also found inspiration in the West's natural architecture, this time in Monument Valley. In Stagecoach, Ford utilizes the visual rhythm of the valley's buttes to frame lines of moving human figures. In his dramatic introduction of the film's primary protagonist, Ford places the Ringo Kid, John Wayne, directly in front of darkened mesas. Here, the quintessential Western hero stands within a quintessential Western landscape, reinforcing the relationship between the rugged individualism of a masculine ideal and the grandeur of a timeless geography. Thanks to Moran and Ford, such harsh landscapes riveted by stone sentinels became iconic of the American West. Indeed, these artists not only meditated on the visual and atmospheric qualities of such starkly beautiful landscapes, but also utilized their striking contrasts of vertical and horizontal masses, of stillness and fluidity, of shadow and light, to distill the essential character of the West and its heroic archetypes. Moran placed Native American figures within a landscape devoid of Euro-American interference, thereby contributing to a popular late 19th century construct equating indigenous nobility with pristine wilderness, both of which, it was implied, belonged to an increasingly distant past. Moving into the 20th century, Ford's union of epic landscape and heroic archetype powerfully appealed to a sense of American identity rooted in its 19th century Western saga. The stone citadels rising above Monument Valley and the Green River became testaments to the kind of resolve necessary to survive in the West, and suggested that only those with requisite tenacity and endurance might stand successfully among the West's most rugged environments.